OMG guys, you're gonna love today's video. We are making this adorable wallet. It is the Diva Frame Wallet from So Many Creations. Jessica Vandenberg is the genius behind these lovely designs. And we're gonna be making it from start to finish in today's video. I really love this wallet. It has a really professional look to it, especially when you combine it with the hardware. And it's got everything you need. It's got all your pockets for your credit cards and your business cards, whatever. You've got a nice big pocket here for your cash or anything else you have. Another big pocket here. And then of course, a change compartment. So it's got everything you need. It's a really nice size, so you can just take it with you if you just need to bring your wallet and nothing else, or it fits nicely in your bag as well. And don't worry, we have bag tutorials coming up too, so you're gonna be able to have something to put this in. Now, you definitely are gonna need to get the pattern to go with this. We're not gonna show you any measurements or cutting instructions for this. All that is available in the pattern. But if you're a visual learner and you've gotten the pattern and you're just not quite sure of how to do a few of the steps, then we're gonna show you step-by-step how to sew it together, so that way you can make one of these for your own. And of course, we've got everything you need to make it over at shop.quiltaddictsanonymous.com. I'm just in love with this one, and I use canvas for my outside. I really like using canvas whenever I'm doing bag projects because it's sturdier and it really holds up very well over time. And so if you're going to spend the time and effort to make yourself a wallet, make it last. So I love that. We have more than just this canvas, but this one was my favorite. All right, let's get started. So we're using Pelon de Corbon for this project. It's really sturdy, so it's gonna give your wallet a lot of body and make it more professional. Whenever you are fusing, what you wanna do is you wanna lay it down with the glue side up of your de Corbon first, and then line up your fabric on the outside of it from there. And then once you've got everything in line, then you can just sort of take your iron, and I like to kind of alternate from side to side. The reason why you do it this way is every once in a while you make a mistake. I've made mistakes where you accidentally get your interfacing going the wrong way. And when you have it going the wrong way and it's on your iron, that's a big mess to clean up. When you fused it to your ironing surface, that can be fixed. All right, let's see how this is together. Yep, that is pretty well fused. I'm happy with that. So go ahead and do that for all your other pieces as well. All right, I'm not gonna show you this part on camera because it gives away too much of the measurements because I have my mat here that has the measuring part on it. But essentially what you're going to do here is you're going to just fold this in half and you're going to give it a press once you've got your edges together. So you're going long ways and you're going to do that for all of the card pockets and then give that the press, and then we're gonna top stitch. But again, I'm just showing this to you here. What you're just gonna do is, again, take it, I've got the wrong side facing out here. You're gonna fold it in half so that the long edges are meeting like this and give it a press. And again, not showing on the camera because we don't want to give away the measurements, because we want you to support Jessica and buy the So Many Creations patterns from us, so that way you can make this cute, adorable little wallet. So I put in my sewing machine thread that is a few shades lighter than the fabric that I'm using. I tend to go a little bit lighter because I feel like it blends a little bit more and is a little bit less obtrusive. So if your stitching isn't perfectly straight, then you can kind of get away with it, you know, hiding a little bit more. So now I'm gonna go ahead and top stitch a quarter inch away from my folded edge on all of the card pockets that we have created. So now we're going to prepare our open pocket. This is what we're going to sew those card pockets to. So I've got my piece of fabric that does not have interfacing on the back with the right side facing up. And then I'm going to place my piece that does have the interfacing on the back facing down. And by sewing with the piece that doesn't have the interfacing on the bottom, that'll help keep it from getting stretched out when we sew this together. These patterns are written for quilters who want to do bags. So almost everything is going to be a quarter inch seam. This one is, so I can just go ahead and sew that quarter inch stitch across that top of the pocket. Now, I'm not gonna show you the pressing on camera either, because we should all know how to press, but mostly I wanna make sure that we're not giving away any of the measurements that you should get in the pattern. But basically what you're gonna do is you're gonna unfold it here, and then you're going to fold it so that the seam is tucked on the inside there. And you're gonna press that to get it nice and crisp. And then we're gonna top stitch across the edge. So I'm gonna top stitch one more time here across the top of that open pocket. All right, so now we're gonna attach our card pockets to our open pocket here. I'm using a measuring gauge here, but you can use your regular ruler that you use for quilting. I'm gonna place the first one so that the top of it is a full half inch away from the top of the pocket. So I'm just aligning my edges and then making sure that that is nice and even. I'm gonna put some pins in here to hold that in place. Now I'm gonna do a stitching line a quarter inch away from this edge. So when I put that in my sewing machine, I'm lining up the edge of my press foot with this raw edge right here. My interfacing side is up, by the way, when I'm doing all that pinning. So I'm gonna keep on adding those card pockets with a half inch in between the top of the last pocket and the start of the second one. Now this last pocket should be nice and even with your bottom. Now what you do next is gonna depend on what size frame you have to go with this. If you purchase a 7.5 inch frame from us, you're going to sew one stitch up into this first card pocket right up through the center. But that'll vary depending on it, so make sure you refer to your pattern instructions to make sure you sew the right one. To find the center, you can measure, or I'm just gonna fold it in half like this. Give myself a little press. And now I can see a nice crease here. It might not be as evident on camera, but I can see that nice crease going right up through the center, and I can use that as my guide for stitching. When I get up to the top, I'm gonna reinforce those stitches by stitching backward and forward a few stitches, and that'll help keep it from pulling apart over time. I should have done this when I was stitching my bottom on, but I'm gonna go ahead and stitch an 1/8 inch stitch around the sides as well to secure these edges. We're doing an 1/8 inch stitch, and you should do an 1/8 inch stitch here on the bottom as well, because that will help conceal everything when you are putting your frame on. All right, so our pocket for our card pocket is an open pocket is done. Now I need to start preparing the zipper pocket, and then we're gonna be ready to put this together. So to install your zipper pocket, you're gonna need to refer to your pattern instructions for the Diva Frame Wallet from So Many Creations. But I'm gonna walk you through the steps without showing you the measurements here. So the first thing I did was I measured in my side measurements, and then I marked that with my friction gel pen. These lines are gonna mark the sides of where my zipper are going to end. Next, I measured down from the top and made a mark here to indicate the top of where my zipper is going to be. Then I drew two more lines, each 1/4 inch down from that top line. So this centerpiece here, that's where the actual zipper is going to be when it's centered. And then this will show where the edges will be. So take the time, mark it out, because then you will end up with the zipper exactly dead center. It will look more professional. This is, by the way, with the interfacing side up that I've done all of this work on. I also drew a tiny little hash mark 1/4 inch in from the side, and then I'm going to connect that to create a V. And these are some lines that we're going to cut on in just a second. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Now taking my micro tip scissors, I'm going to go ahead and cut down the straight center line and also on these Vs to open that up for our zipper pocket. I'm going to start by folding it over exactly on top of itself so I can get that nice little sharp straight line. Now that I've got that open, go ahead and cut the rest of the way down one side, making sure to stop at the tip of that V and then clip out those corners. And then I'm going to cut the rest of this side, again stopping at the V, and then clipping out the corners. Now we have this nice opening and we've got the points. And what's gonna happen is they're gonna fold in real nicely to create a very professional looking pocket. All right, so what we're gonna do next, I'm gonna do this again off camera so that you guys can't see any measurements on my cutting mat. But what you want to do is fold the pieces back along the lines of the rectangle so that you have a nice rectangular opening of where your zipper is. You do wanna make sure that you press really well at this step because that's gonna help hold everything in place for when you are installing your zipper. This next tip is, in my opinion, the best zipper placement tip I have ever heard in my life. And I was so excited to see it when I saw this pattern. So I took some of my Heat and Bond Light that I just have on hand. It's something a lot of quilters have. And I cut it to a 1/4-inch strip. You can also use steam seam for this if you want. And then what you're gonna do is you're going to measure it out to the length of your piece on the back here. This is where your zipper's gonna go. I'm just gonna give it a little tear. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side here. And I'm not being super precise, I just need it to cover the opening that we had from before. So now one at a time, I'm going to fuse this to the wrong side of this bit that we just pressed. And that, it has paper backing on it, so it's just gonna fuse to the fabric and not my iron, which is obviously very important at this step. So when you're buying this, you wanna make sure you're getting the paperback fusible web and not anything else, because you want to be able to work with it one side at a time. All right, so we've got one side down, we're gonna do the other real quick. And I'm getting it kind of close to the edge, but not far enough to where I'm gonna be able to see it, because that's, I don't wanna see that. All right, so now that this has cooled, I'm gonna go ahead and peel off the paper-backed portion of it, making sure that that fusible webbing is still laid down. So working from the right side, I am just arranging this so that my zipper is right in the center of that rectangle that we created, as close as I can get it, and that my zipper pull, when it is fully to the left here, is right up in the far left side there. Once I'm happy with the placement, I'm gonna hit this with an iron and that will activate the fusible and help hold it in place until we can get it stitched down. Now is the time to make any last minute adjustments. And you can iron over zippers, teeth, but obviously don't hang out around them for too long. Especially if you're using a plastic zipper, it could melt, but it's not likely. Once you get everything fused, go ahead and stitch an 1/8-inch stitch all the way around. You can stitch right over zipper teeth, but you do kind of want to go slow as you do it. That way you don't bust the needle. I'm gonna go ahead and stitch a little bit past where I started, then do some back stitching before I cut those threads. All right, so we've got our zipper installed. Always double check to make sure that it's still functioning. You just wanna make sure that that's working before you go any further. And then in this case, you can see I've got my zipper teeth hanging past a little bit. So you can just take your scissors and you can cut off the extra tail. You won't need to worry about it pulling off because once you've sewn over it with thread, it's not gonna move past that point. I'm also gonna clip this little bit extra just to reduce some of the bulk in the final product. So we're gonna take our piece of other zipper pocket fabric that does not have interfacing on it. I'm gonna lay that right sides up. Now I'm gonna take my pocket piece that we installed the zipper in, and I'm gonna lay that right sides together. And I'm just gonna top stitch across the top of this, again, with the piece that does not have interfacing facing the feed dog so it doesn't stretch. Just like we did for the card pockets, I'm gonna go ahead and press this up and get those seam allowances so that they are tucked on the inside. And I'm gonna do this with my fingers first and then I'm gonna take it to the iron. And again, I'm not gonna show that step on the iron because that would give away too much of what the sizing is of this and you've gotta get the pattern for that. All right, I've got everything pressed. Now I'm gonna stitch 1/4-inch away from that folded edge. This top stitching just kinda helps neaten everything up, help it keep a nice sharp fold and helps it make it look a little bit more professional. It doesn't say to do this in directions, but I'm gonna go ahead and do it because we did it for the card pocket. I'm also gonna stitch around all of these raw edges here with an 1/8-inch stitch just to keep those raw edges together to make the next step a little easier. I feel like I've got a mess going over here at this point, but you know what we all do at this point when we're sewing. All right, so now I'm gonna take my two pieces, and I've got my zipper edge that I've got there, and this, by the way, is my body for my accent. This is going to be the inside of the wallet, and it's got interfacing fused to the back. And I'm going to put that at one end and then my card pocket at the other. I'm gonna go ahead and pin these in place. You might find binding clips are a little bit easier because we do kind of have a lot going on here with all the layers and the interfacing. So if that's easier for you, then definitely use those. I'm just going ahead to put some pins in the corners, making sure that those are nice and lined up and straight. You could always pin more than that. I'm not really a big pinner, so I tend to kind of skip it if I feel like I can get away with it. Then I'm also gonna put pins where the edges of the bits are as well. I suppose at this point it's worth mentioning before you sew that this should look like the inside of the wallet is going to look at this point. So all your pockets should be facing up, your zipper should be facing up, you should have the right side of your fabric facing up, because this is what the actual inside of your wallet is going to look like once we finish assembling it. So if it's not, if something's turned around, fix it now before you sew. All right, I've got that back on an 1/8 inch stitch again, and I'm just gonna start sewing kind of in the middle to go around all this, because I feel like there isn't really anything to stitch onto there. So that's a good place to stop and start, because there'll be less stress in the end. All right, I've run around the entire thing. I'm gonna go ahead and do a little back stitching before I break my threads. So I've got some decisions to make at this point. I have a directional fabric. I really love this print. I've loved teal before teal was popular, as you can tell by my studio here. But I just love this print. I think it's really cool. I think it'll be really fun for summer. And this looks like wood grain, so it's a fabulous combination. I love it. But I have to decide which part I want to be up when the wallet is all together. So when I do it, when I open my wallet, do I want it to be going, the bugs to be going this way when I open it up and my coin is on the bottom? And I think I do. I think I want this to be the top. So what I need to do then is I need to arrange it right sides together so that my bugs are facing the top of the card pocket. And I'm going to pin along the long side here. We're gonna leave this part raw because that is going to get tucked into the hardware that goes with this. So I wanna pin on my long left and right sides, and we're gonna sew that up right now. And to make sure that this stays nice and even, I'm actually gonna pin both sides at one time as I go down here. That way I can keep them nice and even. And again, this is really thick at this point, so you might be better off going with some heavy duty pins or some clips at this point, just because it is a lot to fit in. I'm gonna go ahead and pin at the centers as well. And this is a little different than the pattern tells you. The pattern tells you to pin across the top and the bottom, but I'm just so used to pinning across where my pins are that would feel weird to me. But if you wanna follow the way it's written in the pattern, that's perfectly fine. All right, so now I'm gonna sew 1/4 inch seam down both of these edges here, the long sides on the left and right of the wallet. And in this case, since this is one of the final seams we're going to have in here, I am going to reinforce my stitches at the front and end of those seams just to help keep everything together and be sturdier over time. Flip it over so that I'm sewing from the same top to the same bottom. I once did some curtains where I kind of sewed in opposite directions, and let's just say that it was 8 feet of not so nice words as I was ripping that seam out because it just shifted and it didn't hang right. All right, so I finished stitching, and then there's one more thing that you should do, again, that we're not gonna show on camera so that you can't see the sizing on the rotary cutter for this, but I'm gonna trim these seams down to an 1/8 inch seam allowance. That is just so that we have a little bit less bulk in the ends of the wallet, and also it's gonna help it turn a little bit easier. All right, now I'm gonna turn this inside out. I'm gonna start by just gently turning over that first part so that I don't rip those ends, and then I'm gonna kind of grab from the back and pull that through. Everything nice and flattened out. I'm gonna give this a press so that it lays a lot flatter and that we don't have the outside part rolling into the center. We want this to be nice and flat. So feel free to use some spray starch if you need to. Now, just like a lot of the things we're doing, we're going to go ahead and stitch this top edge closed with an 1/8 inch seam allowance. It's gonna make it easier to apply the frame, but we're almost done. It's looking like a wallet at this point. I am loving the way this looks. It's super cute. I love my little buggies. They're adorable. All right, so I'm gonna stitch across the top and the bottom with that 1/8 inch seam allowance, then we're gonna get our hardware on. All right, so now's a good time to make sure that everything is going to fit inside your wallet frame. Obviously, if it doesn't, then you need to take a little bit deeper stitch on the inside so that way you can snug it up just a little bit more. This one is fitting pretty well on that side. So I'm gonna double check on the other side as well. All right, we're doing quite well on this side as well. Okay, so this frame has a nice little clip lock there. So that way it'll hold it nicely in place in the end. But what that means is that we have to take a little bit of fabric out of here so that way it has room to pass through. So again, I'm just taking my trusty Frixion gel pen and I'm just going to trace around where that is, making sure that I am really leaning that pen into the hole where that is so I can get a nice good line. You can see here where it's going to be. So what I need to do is I need to stitch just outside of that. So right about here. And that will help hold everything together so that I can clip that out and it will still function and be a gray bag. I'm gonna go ahead and reinforce these stitches just so that it's nice and strong hold there. But I'm just sewing right around that rectangle that I drew around where everything is going to be. Reinforce the stitches again. Get a nice, good, strong closure there. All right, this part may seem a little scary, but we're gonna go ahead and clip that out. I'm just gonna cut just inside where I sewed. And I'm using my microtip scissors for that because they have a really sharp edge, so I know that I can get really precise cuts here, even going through all those layers. I'm just gonna double check that that fits one more time. And it does, it looks pretty good. It's going pretty good on the inside of there. Now, there is really two ways you can go here. This comes with a bunch of teeny tiny little screws in it. And actually this is a screw side that's supposed to be inside of it. And you can use an eyeglass screw case. I've got some tiny little screwdrivers here that I like to have just in my sewing kit because it's useful for changing needles out and things like that. You could just screw it on. That's not gonna be as permanent as if you use Gutermann glue. This is really strong stuff. I recommend using it outdoors. I'm actually gonna crack a window here in my sewing space before I use it because it really does, it's got some odor to it, but it's really good stuff. And we're just going to put a little bead of it in the track of each of these. And then we're just gonna slide it on top and then apply our screws. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna figure out which screw is going to fit in these teeny tiny little screws. And that way I've got everything ready to go once I go with my glue. All right, so I'm just gonna put a little bit in the track here. A little bit really goes a long way with this glue. I feel like once you start to squeeze it, it just wants to kind of keep on going out. So I'm just gonna put that back in there for right now. All right. Now try not to glue my fingers or the extra fabric. get a little on the frame, by the way. I just kind of nudged it off with the edge there. That way I could just snug it in and it wouldn't get stuck anywhere. Okay. So now I'm just kind of shoving that in there, trying to get the edges of my fabric all the way to the edge of where the glue is. I want to make sure that I don't have any coming out on the ends. I don't. We're good there. Just kind of really pinching that together. And then while that's drying, I'm going to start also putting these screws in. All right, so these screws don't really tighten the way you would expect a screw to. But what it does is it kind of pinches everything together. So between that and the Gutermann glue, you're gonna get a good strong hold there. You're gonna be okay. All right, now I'm gonna repeat on the other side. Again, you wanna make sure that the screw holes are facing you or the inside of your wallet. This is still oozing out from the last time I squeezed it. Again, just getting that nice thin line down the edges. When I'm done, just put it right back in here. Trim off a couple of stray threads here before I shove that in there. Should have done that first if you're following along at home. All right, I got a little glue stuck to the front there. So again, I'm just gonna wipe that off on the edges, which are gonna go in the center. Just gonna fit that in there as nicely as I can. All right, so I know it's super tempting to just go out and use this right away, but you wanna let this glue set up for at least 24 hours before you start using it to give it a chance to really bond and really be nicely tied in to this so that it's not gonna go anywhere. Those screws are good. They're not gonna be long-lasting solution on their own. So make sure that you use that Gutermann glue, give it time to set up, get a good, nice hold on there, and then you're good to go. If you get any glue on your fabric, you can kind of pick it off once it dries or your hardware. You also can pick off any errant threads that are hanging out. We have some here that didn't get clipped. So I can just kind of grab those with my little scissors, just get as close as you can to them and pull them off and they'll be good to go. Thanks so much for following along with this week's video tutorial, and thanks for Jessica Vandenberg of So Many Creations for making such a lovely pattern for us to follow along with. Everything you need to get this, except for the little zippers, you can get over at shop.quiltaddictsanonymous.com. We have the pattern, we've got all the hardware, we've got some fabric. I think we're gonna do up little mini kits of this, so if you wanna get some that has the same fabric we used, and the hardware, then you'll be able to grab that. So if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more of it, there are a couple things you can do. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel, and then you will get at least one new video a week. Sometimes we do two, you get a bonus. And then you also can subscribe to our email list so that you don't miss out on anything new and you can know what new products we have in store. And a good way to say thank you and support us is when you see a project like this that you want to give a go, then get the supplies from us and it helps us support us so we can continue to make more free videos for you. Thanks so much, and until next time, happy quilting, and in this case, bag making. And where did I put my zipper when I came in? That will be helpful to know. Clutch a wallet. It's a wallet. Oh, come on, kitty. I'm trying to catch a fly. Cat is currently trying to catch a fly. She might succeed.